Hi everyone. Hello and welcome to another video where I am once again shamelessly using you to motivate myself to finally get my Italian homework done. I have two assignments that I need to complete. Well, the thing is, they don't exactly have a deadline. The teacher literally said, get them done before the end of the school year, so that is not helpful to me. So to motivate myself to get them done earlier, I am doing it together with you. So this is a bit of a more casual video again, in the sense that it's daylight, as you can tell by that bird. Yeah, but it's gonna stop. The bird is gonna stop. It's about 8 p.m. now, so in the coming half an hour, 2 hour, it's going to get progressively darker outside and the bird will calm down. But I just really wanted to get started on this, okay? I also have my phone on. So I have two assignments that I need to get done. I think one is a listening assignment and one is a reading assignment. So I have my laptop here because they are on there. But I think I will need my book to do them. We're working with Nuovo Espresso 2. So that's my textbook. But so I also missed last week's class. So after the assignments, if they haven't taken me too long yet, I also kind of want to check out what they did last week and see if I can sort of make up for that a little bit already, but we'll see. I don't want to be here for too long. Okay, so I don't know how much I'll be talking. I expect not too much, actually. Okay, so I need my laptop. The assignments are on my laptop, but there's a reason that I have not ever created a video with my laptop when it is functioning, because I find that it has a rather loud fan, and for some reason the fan also very easily starts, so even when I'm not, you know, asking a lot from it, the fan will still start going. So I apologize for that. You know, this is a bit more of a casual video, so it's one of those ones that is kind of more for me than for you. So maybe some of you will enjoy it, and otherwise, well, you know, that's life, isn't it? Okay, so I'm gonna start the laptop. So I don't know when the fan will start going. See, it's already starting. I think it's pretty quiet now still, but it can get worse. But so, just me making the screen a little brighter was enough to aggravate it. Okay, so let's start with the reading assignment. It says, I'll do a little bit of speaking just because I don't personally like super quiet videos, but I'm very much a novice in Italian, okay? So this is technically my second year, but my first year was kind of like a cheap, not even a school, it was like a voluntary thing. So the teacher was a volunteer, he was a retired heart surgeon, and he was very old school. Like, literally very old. He was almost 80. So in that first entire year, I basically did not do any speaking of my own. So this year I went to an actual school. But so, my accent anyway, so what I'm supposed to do. Leggete i testi a pagina 66 di Nuovo Espresso 2. Anche la seconda pagina di questo documento. Rispondete alle domande e spedite le risposte alla tua insegnante. Okay. So, 66. So the chapter was all about like going places, asking people to go with you somewhere, refusing, blah blah blah. Okay, so leggi i testi e abbina ogni evento al profilo culturale più adatto. Dove fai se? There are five options, so dove fai se? Sei un'appassionata di libri? Sei un appassionato di cinema? Sei un appassionato di lingua e cultura italiana? Ti piacciono il cibo e i vini italiani? E sei un appassionato di opera. question is to match up those options with each event. Salone Internazionale del Libro a Torino, so 1B, 1B, 2, sei un appassionato di cinema, Mostra Internazionale d'Arte Cinematografica di Venezia, fino a So the second question is, dove ha abitato Puccini? Quando è il festival pucciniano? A luglio e agosto. Quando posso andare al Salone Internazionale del Libro a Torino? Quando posso andare? Ogni anno a maggio. Come si chiama il premio della Mostra Internazionale d'Arte Cinematografica di Venezia? Come si chiama il premio? Question is, che cosa posso fare nei negozi italiani tranne comprare del cibo? Except from buying. Corsi di degustazione. corsi di cucina. Poi assaggiare e conoscere meglio. First exercise, which was really short and easy. Oh, there's a header as well. I just saw in the second file that there's a header that I didn't fill in. Okay. Thank you. somewhere else. Okay, so the listening exercise. Che serata, ascoltate, track. Okay, so I have never actually looked up one of these listening tracks. Well, because we listen to them in class, and I have no reason to listen to them more at home. So I need to find this track now. So I'm going to go to the website. Do I need audio? Per andare in costruzione abbia la possibilità di scrivere gratuitamente tutti gli audio della lezione. Okay, so it should log in. You have to register first. I hate registering. I'm not a robot, which I always, always have so much trouble with. Like, right now, I'm absolutely not sure about this letter. I fucking hate it. I do not want the newsletter. Sign up. Open your email. I was doing this just on my own, there would have been so many times that I would have quit already. The fan is really, really going now. Per attivare l'account, fai click. I love how Italians use English words. Fai click sul link. Okay, so attivazione completata. Now I have to log in. I want to get back to where I was when this whole thing started of making me log in. Can you do that website, please? I'm just gonna go back to my search engine. And now I should be logged in already. Yes, okay, I'm logged in and I can go to no. Now I am back where I was. Okay, now the zip file is opening and then saving. Track, where is track 14? Did I need to get the other one? Oh, for fuck's sake. It said 6. Listen. Wait, what do I need to do while I listen? Vere o false? E scrive perché? Okay. So, I just had my first listen. I am very bad at listening exercises. I always have been, whether it is in my own native language, which is Dutch, or in English or French or Italian or German back in the day. I am terrible at listening exercises. It's one of the reasons I don't like phone calls either. I do not have the attention span for telephone calls. So, but based on my first listen, a woman is talking about how she went to the theater. Then there is something about getting drinks before the theater, but I didn't catch all of that, and I have a couple questions that I need to answer, so I have to listen again. And then when she was at the theater, some people were talking all the time and she got really annoyed. And then during the break, she went to the bathroom or something, she came back and other people were sitting in her seats, and they said that they couldn't see in their own seats, so they found others. But she asked him to leave, but afterwards she was so annoyed that she couldn't focus anymore. Okay, but now I need to figure out what happened with the drinks. So I have to find out if the statement is prima di andare a teatro hanno bevuto un aperitivo a casa. And I know that is not true, but I don't know exactly how to explain it yet. And then sono andati a teatro con I mezzi pubblici. And I know that she mentioned public transportation, but to go to the drinks, but I don't know if she also took it to go to the theater then. And sono arrivati a teatro puntuali. And I know she was late to drinks, but I don't know if she was also late to the theater. So I have to listen again to find out. So here goes. He just said that it took them an hour at her house to decide which bar to go to for drinks. So I'm going to try to put that into a sentence. Sono rimasti a casa sua per una let's keep listening. So, I don't think she arrived in time, and she said that she hates arriving when the show already started. So what am I, how am I gonna explain? Sono arrivati a teatro puntuali. No, e dice che odia? I could say that. To say something like no, because they had so much trouble finding parking. No, perché non possono. Okay, so no, perché I need to put this in past tense, so perché era difficile trovare parcheggio. No, perché era difficile trovare parcheggio. Three truths and three falses, I only have to explain when it's false. So, let me check if everything is clear. And if you don't want to know, alcune the persone chiacchieravano e quando sono tornati dopo le pause hanno trovato le poltrone occupate. That is true. Okay, so then this assignment is complete as well. Okay, so and the video is already like 45 minutes. So let's upload these to the school platform, and see what they did last week, quickly. Assignments, assignments, assignments. Okay, so the reading is first. Listening assignment. Upload. And save. Okay, so those are done. So that means I can finally take this off my phone to-do list. Finally. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you for being my motivation. And now I'm going to check last week's class. So, lezione a scuola 20 aprile. First, it says when the next classes at school are going to be, because some are online and some are not. So the next is, yeah, I have that noted. Oh, and this one is also going to be in school, so I need to change that. It's not going to be online, but at school. Okay, I can school that. Okay, May is the 5th month, right? Yeah, yes. Okay, and then in June, that week and that week. Okay, already. Oh. And then it says, che ne dite, facciamo una lezione all'aperto, si fa bel tempo. Okay, then they did these quick fire vocab exercises, so happy to miss out on those. Riprendiamo il gerundio, fotocopia documento su Moodle, plus but I don't need to repeat the gerund already knew it before she taught it, so I am all okay. Quattro ti fa di venire. Ok, 58, pagina 58. Ok, la macchina l'ho portata dal meccanico. Ascolta il dialogo e completa. Oh, I have to listen again. Track 13, avercela. I really suck at the verb avercela. Something, something, rimaniamo. But come. Thank you. So it turns out the things you had to fill in were not related to the verb avercela, but it does use avercela in the dialogue. That's an exercise that is here on line. So I am going to try to do the exercise in do we need to do? The exercise is on the use of lo, la, li, and le con passato prossimo. Esempi: ieri Alberto ha mangiato una mela. Ieri l'ha mangiata. Oh, ok. Gotcha. Angelo ha spedito I regali in Italia. Li. È già partita? Sì. Dove hai messo I miei occhiali? Lì. Ho messi nella borsa. Sai dove? Le ho viste poco fa sul tavolo. Dove hai comprato quella sciarpa? Là. L'ho comprata in un piccolo negozio. Avete già speso tutti I and the sea. Now there is a correction for this exercise, so let me see how I did. Okay, so l'ho già visto, correct. L'ho imparata, correct. L'ho accompagnata. So they asked avete, which is the plural you. So I should have replied li abbiamo. What else did they do? 59. Hai già. I just want to do this bit here. I biglietti li ho presi. Sì. Okay. And the rule is quando prima di un verbo al passato prossimo c'è un pronome diretto, lo, la, li, le, o il pronome ne, il participio passato concorda con l'oggetto. Okay, so I guess that was the little theory. Hai già. Ecco una lista di cose che avresti dovuto fare questa settimana. Scegli quattro cose che hai fatto. Il tuo compagno deve scoprire con sole con 5 domande. Quali sono? Ok, so that is like a speaking exercise. Another pubblici buone maniere. This is a reading exercise, I guess. Le buone maniere nei luoghi pubblici. Sottolinea nel testo le frasi che corrispondono ai disegni. Okay, that's easy. So there's 5 drawings. We have someone on the phone here. So this is one. Proprio vogliamo mangiare qualcosa, cerchiamo di non far rumore con la carta. So this is two. Theater, I guess. Se arriviamo tardi, andiamo per... I don't really know what this is supposed to be. For museum. Evitiamo di leggere la guida ad alta voce. That's not what he's doing though. Non rimaniamo per ore davanti. That's what he's doing. So this is for... I understand why you need to underline it, because there's two options, but with the other ones, it's not the case. And here, this exercise they didn't do, but for some reason I have to go here and why exactly? Let me look. I pronomi. What is this about? Okay. So it's about I pronomi relativi che è qui. soporto. Another speaking exercise that I missed. What a shame. And then they apparently watched a video. Sara Firenze. Guardiamo insieme e rispondete alle domande. There's one other file here, let me just check it with an exercise, and it has a correction too, so maybe I can do that and then I'm done. Okay, so this is an exercise on avere. Let me try. You know, who cares if it's all wrong? It's not like anyone knows. So let me try. So I am vocabulario. I would say si, ci, lo. Let me look at the correction, just the first one, to see if this is even what they're asking. No. I'm gonna see more if I do that. So let me just muddle along and I'll see afterwards. Ai I documenti si c'è what I think. I did what I think you needed to do. Now we're going to correct it. One. Cielo. Yes, correct. Si. Cielo. Correct. No. Non cielo. Correct. No. Non cielo. Correct. Si. Cielo. Because I'm tired of it. And I'm totally allowed to be. It has been a shit long time. So, time to go check on my cat. Okay. Thank you for being my motivation. And, maybe someone liked this super boring video. Hope you did, and otherwise, better luck next week. Okay. Bye.